Modern cars have brakes on all four wheels, operated by a hydraulic system. Fred Duesenberg originated hydraulic brakes on his 1914 racing cars, and he was the first automotive marque to use the technology on a passenger car in 1921. In 1918, Malcolm Lockheed developed a hydraulic brake system. The technology was carried forward in automotive use and eventually led to the introduction of the self-energizing hydraulic drum brake system, which is still in use today. Hello everybody, and welcome to our series of How Braking System Works. In today's video, we will explore about how the hydraulic braking system works. The brakes may be disc type or drum type. The front brakes play a greater part in stopping the car than the rear ones, because braking throws the car weight forward onto the front wheels. Many cars therefore have disc brakes, which are generally more efficient at the front, and drum brakes at the rear. All disc braking systems are used on some expensive or high performance cars, and all drum systems on some older and smaller cars. Meaning of hydraulics. Hydraulics is the use of a liquid under pressure to transfer force or motion, or to increase an applied force. Pressure on a liquid is called hydraulic pressure. It is hydraulic pressure that forces the brake, shoe or pads into contact with the rotating drum or disc to produce braking. Compressibility of liquids. Increasing the pressure on a gas will compress it into a smaller volume. However, increasing the pressure on a liquid will not compress it. The liquid is incompressible. This makes it possible to use the pressure on liquids in hydraulic systems to transmit force or motion. Transmission of motion by a liquid. The figure shows two pistons in a cylinder with a liquid between the pistons. When the input or apply piston is pushed in 8 inches, the output piston will be pushed the same distance. Motion can be sent from one cylinder to another by a tube, as you can see in the figure. As the apply piston moves, it forces pressurized fluid through the tube and into the other cylinder. This forces the output piston to move. Transferring force by a liquid. The force that is applied to a liquid is transmitted by the liquid in all directions to every part of the liquid. The piston in the figure has an area of 1 square inch, which is 6.45 cubic centimeters. It is applying a force of 100 pounds, that is 445 newton. This is 100 pounds per square inch, which becomes 690 kilopascal. Note that regardless of position, all gauges in the figure show a pressure of 100 psi. The size of the piston also determines pressure. In figure, the piston area is increased to 2 square inches when the same force of 100 pounds is applied over double the area. The resulting pressure is only 50 psi, that is 345 kilopascal, which becomes just the half. Figure shows a hydraulic system with output pistons of different sizes. The bigger the output piston, the greater the output force. For example, in a disc brake system, an apply force of 100 pounds causes a smaller diameter piston in the master cylinder to travel a relatively long distance. The resulting hydraulic pressure then moves a much larger piston in the disc brake a relatively short distance. However, the larger piston has a greatly increased output force. Brake action. The service braking system includes two basic parts. These are the master cylinder and the drum and disc wheel brake mechanisms. The master cylinder is a reciprocating piston pump. It pressurizes the hydraulic system when the driver depresses the brake pedal. This converts the mechanical force from the brake pedal into the hydraulic force that applies the brake at the wheels. Braking begins at the brake pedal. When the pedal is pushed down, brake fluid is forced from the master cylinder into the lines to the wheel brakes. As hydraulic pressure increases, brake shoes or pads are forced against the rotating drums or disc. The resulting friction slows or stops the wheels and the vehicle. Figure shows the basic service brake hydraulic system. There are two pistons in the master cylinder. the spaces ahead of the pistons form two pressure chambers. When the pedal is pushed down, the pistons are pushed towards the closed end of the master cylinder. In this figure, this sends fluid from the front pressure chamber to the front wheel brakes. Fluid from the rear chamber is sent to the rear wheel brakes. Or four brakes then operate to slow and stop the vehicle. This arrangement using a two-piston tandem or dual master cylinder is a dual braking system. In a dual braking system, the hydraulic system has a primary section and a secondary section. The primary section is always closest to the firewall. However, the dual braking system is hydraulically separated or split in different ways. Most vehicles with rear wheel drive use the front rear split. Many front wheel drive vehicles use the diagonal split. Splitting the hydraulic system into two sections improves vehicle safety. One section will continue to work and stop the vehicle if the other section leaks and fails. Both sections seldom fail at the same time. In earlier braking systems, there was only one piston in the master cylinder and one hydraulic system. A leak or failure anywhere in the hydraulic system usually meant that there were no brakes. This was all about the hydraulic braking system. In the next video, we will continue with the drum brakes. So stay tuned and see you guys.